men. As you know, we here in TNC Martin's are not involved in any way in this strike which I believe is about to take place. Now, I have here a form which I want you all to sign, and it says, and I quote, that we will accept and deliver all goods from whatever source. I trust you will be responsible about it. Here's all of that.
Well, boys, it looks like we will be on strike the fall on. Larkin's organising, so it will be out with the pickets.
I mean, it's about time. How can we live in the pittance of a wage we get here? We barely have enough to buy food, pay the rent. After that, you wouldn't have the price of a fag or a pint. And the buses, they're living up to the bloody hilt.
Well, that's true.
So I don't suppose there's anything wrong with a fair day's work for a fair day's pay. Not great faith in Jim Larkin.
Men, I'm going on strike. It'll give us an opportunity to better ourselves. Now I want a show of hands. All those in favour? All those against? Right, we're going out and we're going on strike.
Well, Bill, how's the picketing gone?
Not too bad, Matt, not too bad. The lads are out there walking up and down and telling yarns. Of course, it's a serious business. It has to be done. It can be very boring, but it has to be done.
Yeah, but it's a just cause, Bill. I mean, I hope it doesn't go on too long. Those fellas out there, they have to feed their families and keep a roof over their heads.
It's true, boy, Matt. Which reminds me, I'm here today to give you a strength here.
But Bill, I don't need it. You'd better off giving it to those poor devils out there.
You have to live too, man. You have to live too.
Will you have a cup of tea, Bill?
I haven't got the time to see them all the lads and give them just like this.
Okay, my God. God bless.
God bless you. God bless you.
Well, lads, it was a waste of time going on strike. We gained nothing.
Ah, you're wrong, Jim. I mean, there was a principle involved here. And we didn't sign any agreement.
It was the man that let Larkin down. He done his job. But there's hope for the future.
Well, Matt, what does the church think about strikers? Are we all heathens?
The church is there to guide us. We should all look for some guidance. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Don't take much well at all. Morning, Matt.
Morning, Tom.
Well, the strike is over. What do you think of that?
Ah, thank God. We can all earn a few bob now.
Mass, where are you off to?
Good morning, Mrs. O'Brien. I'm off to Dominic Street for the 10 o'clock Mass.
You're looking weak. Are you all right?
Should a good Lord look after me. Good morning, Mrs. O'Brien. Good
morning, Mass.
Are you all right?
Hey, missus, give us a hand here.
What happened?
I don't know. He just fell. Somebody better go for the priest.
I'll go. There's a poor old man after collapsing up the lane.
Oh, my God, I am heartily sorry for having offended thee. I detest my sins above every other evil, because they displease thee, my God, who for thine infinite goodness is so deserving of all my love, and I firmly resolve by thy holy grace never more to offend thee and to amend my life. In nomine Patri, et Filii, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Matt Talbot has served his city and country well. We may ask, how have they served him? Perhaps we do not want to be reminded of this poor, ill-clad Dublin labourer who walks like a ghost across the conscience of a generation so much better off than his. The Irish trade union movement of his day had many heroes. Some are honoured, some are forgotten. Surely Matt was typical of the thousands of small, ordinary Dublin workers who stood tall and challenged and changed a rotten way of life. However much the moderns may strive to remove the cross from life, it must and will remain. Only in its shadow may we shelter from that which would blind us to our rightful life, end and destiny. We can remember today one who embraced that cross. We can do no less. We can do no better.